Magandang araw po. I am Shen, and I have been with Sibat for 15 years. Sibat's vision was basically to connect. We started out consisting of representatives of non-government organizations from 9 regions of the country. Our goal is to connect NGOs to promote sustainable agriculture and appropriate technology to address problems of poverty and maldevelopment in the Philippine countryside. Appropriate technology basically is technology designed with special and very careful consideration for the community it is intended for. Sustainable agriculture, on the other hand, integrates environmental stewardship, farm profitability, and prosperous farming communities. The development, promotion, and popularization of appropriate technology and sustainable agriculture for genuine rural development has been Sibat's mission for the last 25 years. For more than 2 decades now, Sibat continues to address issues of food insecurity and poverty in the poorest areas of the country, which typically are farming communities found in remote agricultural typologies ranging from lowland sloping to mountainous. These are resource-scarce areas where socioeconomic conditions of people are commonly described to be with low productivity and incomes. Together with local partners and people's organizations, or POs, Sibat studies the varied conditions of underdevelopment gripping many rural communities, particularly in Philippine uplands. Appropriate technology development and sustainable agriculture, alongside the struggle waged by farmers for their right to land and resources, are at the core of our collaboration among members of the network. Appropriate technology and sustainable agriculture continues to be relevant as it builds local capability and self-reliance, fosters adaptability to local cultures and conditions, and promotes strengthening of local organizations.
Naimbangal daw kada tayo amin. I am Frank and I am Sibat's mechanical engineer for the past 10 years. The thirst for sustainable sources of clean water for drinking, irrigation, electrification, and other requirements is one of Sibat's core projects. Funded by the United Nations Development Program, Sibat's micro-hydropower project, which produces 7.5 kilowatts for agricultural use, in addition to providing electricity for the 43 households of a remote upland community in the province of Apayao, is one project that Sibat is proud of. The project is in the remote sitio of Buneg in the province of Apayao in the Cordilleras. To reach the community, one has to hike for at least 8 to 10 hours for the uninitiated. A community as remote as this seldom or have no access to public services such as basic electricity. But through Sibat, a 7.5 kilowatt micro hydropower project was completed in September 2007 through the community's unity, cooperation, and perseverance. A micro hydro is a renewable energy system that uses the water to produce useful energy. This is Ma'am Gina. She is the local teacher in the area and she teaches combined grades due to the lack of teachers assigned to the community.
Idi sir, talaga nga narigat ti situation ti pupils idi. Talaga nga narigat ta. Idi nga binawang pa lang ti microhydro kit narigat ti agistadi ti rabi i babaen ta awan ti silaw. Mapan ka pa iti ka aruba no, daduma na ta agbiro ka karun ti kwada adaan ti gas. Daduma na pa ikit agistadi kami ti saling. Hangu mapupu, hambi pa mapupuutan eh, no, kas ano, adagayam na puuran, ijay banger nga, kwan. Paid stili brumin, kaputa awang nga ti, I want ti, mausar nga iga, gas. Awang pa'y dadumanan kit awan ti igatang ti peres mitigas iso nga marigatan kami nga agistadi. Hang kami pa'y nga makarami ti assignment mi. Gaputa kurang ti oras mi ti. Wino awan ti gas nga usarin mi nga agaramid kadagiti assignment mi ti rabi. Iso nga ito no agsapan ikam kamakambintun sakbay mi nga umay ti eskwelaan.
This is Manang Juliana. Aside from doing traditional household and family chores, she also plays an important role in the food production work. The task of pounding rice is usually done by the women and children. To ease this burden, the Micro Hydro Power Project runs a communally owned rice mill.
Siya dia yaman min unay mit chair kit si datun ita ta adumitinti mangkalinawan min gaputa awadud silawa mikrohydro nga in tulong yuukan na kami nga kakaasit tun igomit tun bunog kumadaton adi kami mambayo adi kami manggatang sigas adi kami salongon gaputa awad light si datun sa tunon radio yusir ud nanam ayam mi gaputa awad intod yung nga bat datun mikrohydron ikayo in tuyod hitun in tuyong hitun igomin nakakaasin igaw makad adayo man nukaan min tikit no asun tumit si panagdrabaho mi di sir uray pe no inyan kamo kumi kumang man trabaho dit nalarga kami ayago pa ilaing gaputa na idud ilang minadaan nubokon na unog ibuwer nubokon na masapa kami akita manlarga at ignarud silaw mi pay laing hindi kit situn itan mabalin laing nga uray no mga lasingko lasais sa kamin to manlarga no han adayo kit alas 5 mabali na larga kami gaputa adayo din pag naan mi din ang papuwa mi din katalunan mi.
Tariffs are collected from the services rendered by the micro hydro power system for the maintenance of its various components and for the honorarium of the operators. These tariffs can be in the form of cash or in kind. Being a community-based renewable energy system, it is implemented, owned, managed, and sustained by the community of Buneg through the local people's organization, the Buneg Mabaka Tribal Organization or BMTO. The members themselves see to it that timely collection of tariffs and maintenance of the various components of the system are accomplished. The community of Buneg looks forward to a better tomorrow, knowing full well that with a 7.5 micro hydro power system that they fully control, own, and manage, opportunities and options open up to them.
Hi, I'm Joe. I'm SIPAT's Program Coordinator for Renewable Energy since 2002. A new dawn rises over our partner community called Takilay, a remote upland community that can be found in South Cotabato. It can be reached through an hour's hike through narrow mountain trails after a 30-minute ride from the capital city of Coronadal. Harnessing energy from the sun was something unthinkable for the remote upland village of Takilay in South Cotabato. More so, that it can be used to pump water for domestic use of small indigenous tribe of the Blaans. But for over 12 years, the community of Takilay has largely benefited from the longest-running community-based solar water pumping project in the country. In keeping with the Blaan tradition, women and children feel this huge impact since they daily fetch water for their respective households. Not just as mere consumers, they get to maintain, own, and sustain the solar water pump projects themselves. Manong Tomas and Yeli Gaya were designated as project operators. Here is what they have to say about the project.
Tanungin nila kung anong problemahin namin dito. Sinabi naman ay mga tao dito, malaking problemahin namin. Siguro hindi kaya ng problema, number one, tubig ng kinanlan namin.
Doon namin makita na mababawasan ng oras na magamit namin sa napuhay. Yung mga babae, maligaya na sila, at saka yung mga anak namin, nakapaligo na. Pati ng mga lalaki, minsan na sila pumunta sa tubig. Doon na sila sa ilang uma. Ang matulungan ng tubig, ang mga anak namin nakapag-aral na. Dahil yung oras namin magtatrabaho, nagsasimula alas 6 hanggang alas 11. Malaking nakita sa bawat isa. Hindi kagaya noon, marayo pang tubig. Ang oras ginagamit na pag pumunta sa uma, ginagamit pa sa pag-igib ng tubig.
Solar water pumping technology is most appropriate for Taquilay due to the absence of other viable sources of energy. Tribal leader Rexa Unan speaks for the community about the benefits of the solar water pumping project.
Dito, lahat kami, isa-asa kami, lahat sa mga komunidad. Ang gusto ko yung dito, hindi na pwede bayaan. Kahit na palangga yung mga anak, kahit mga anak natin, ito ng mga project, lahat ito, mga komunidad dito. Dapat ito, tutulungan namin ito ng kwan.
Sibat is committed to providing technical trainings to the community to ensure continuity of the project and its benefits. The strength of people's unity, traditional cooperation, and unrelenting resolve chiefly facilitated the successful implementation of the project.
Aside from micro-hydro projects, Sibat also developed solar wind turbine systems in Lubang Island in Mindoro and two systems in Lamag, Quirino, Ilocos Sur. They are used to produce electricity for lighting, battery charging, water pumping, and powering small post-harvest facilities like sugarcane presses. Combined, these two projects benefit 200 households.
I've been working with Sibat for 5 years. I'm an agriculturist and I'm doing sustainable agriculture in the communities in Central Visayas. Simply put, sustainable agriculture is a system of farming that does not harm the environment. My project is community-based sustainable agriculture and water systems in Bohol, the land of the famous Chocolate Hills. Our exact destination is the farmlands of Sitio Panaghiusa, Barangay San Vicente in the municipality of Trinidad, Bohol. It can be reached by a 30 to 45 minute habal-habal ride. Its farmers, led by the Trinidad Taliban Integrated Farmers Association, or TITIFA, had gained ownership and control of their land in almost 20 years. Since then, they had sustained their collective efforts in improving their lives by addressing problems in food production. The farmers of Trinidad used to grow rice relying on chemical inputs. They had suffered low productivity, experiencing 6 to 7 lean months each year due to decreasing productivity of the chemical degraded soil, the impact of extreme weather conditions, and the inability to meet the spiraling costs of inputs. This is why they changed to cash crops such as oil palm and became victims of corporate oil palm plantations. The farmers of Trinidad also become victims of loan sharks. I would like you to meet Kuya Loren, the chairman of TITIFA, the Taliban Trinidad Integrated Farmers Association.
Okay, training ko sa Sibat, sa Pardik, para makakat-on ko sa unsa pa di ay ang panglaw tayong pagpanguma. Kikatabang ang pag-apply sa sustainable agriculture, mala tayong pagpanguma. Ngunit kay dili na gastuso, dili naman ta mangutang o abono sa itong tanong para pagpalambo. Mao ni ako ang vermiculture para sa kuha na ko o kung abono sa ako ang mga tanom. O makatambok ni sa ako ang mga tanom, pili na ko magagamit atong mga commercial nga abono kini na gid akong gigamit.
Community-based sustainable agriculture was introduced through a project partnership among Sibat, Titifa, and the local NGO FARDEC, the Farmers Development Center Incorporated. Sustainable agriculture is a farming system designed to be productive in the short and long term, while ensuring technological appropriateness, ecological soundness, economic viability, and social justice. A water project was also installed in the community through the cooperative labor of the community in partnership with Sibat and FARDEC as a support to food production and needs of households. Some people say that sustainable agriculture is a more difficult way to farm, but Kuya Lawrence's experience proves otherwise. Atong i-aplikar ang malahutayong pagpanguma.
Few Flavie de Calbong. I am Lala and I'm with Sibat for 6 years. I'm the sustainable agriculture staff for Mindanao. I joined Sibat because I believe that their cause for appropriate technology is really based on community strength and culture. To reach the community, we have to ride the habal-habal. It is a single motorcycle from the center of Malapatan municipality. Then we have to trek the mountains for around 8 hours. It gets harder during the rainy season when river swells and the trails get slippery. The Blans inhabit the province of Sarangani. They are a cluster of communities comprised by the second largest group of Lumads in Mindanao. Situated between two mountain ranges, the Loncan Range and the Langali Latian Range, the Datalnay and Lumay cluster are Blan communities comprised of 6 villages in the Aplon Barangay of Upper Suyan, Malapatan in Sarangani province. Ariel R. Aye is the staff of Center for Lumad Advocacy and Services assigned in the Talnay. He is also a member of the Blaan tribe.
Muna talong din eh, abyo, galon, muna mo din eh, di Lumoy. Kung ka ng pangalan nila sa Lumoy, hindi kahoy na, sapa. Pagka may sunod lang eh.
The Blans have been the primary force in transforming their conditions and confronting the problems in their communities. Sibat provides assistance by forging partnership with the local NGO in utilizing appropriate technology in the transformation process. Indigenous knowledge of the Blans are the starting point in this participatory technology development process.
Working with Sibat has taught me humility and that learning is a two-way process. And development is not only for a few, but most importantly, should include the indigenous peoples who have been neglected for so long.
Sibat's assistance to farmers and communities are not limited to the countryside. Sibat and its local partners have proven that organic gardening and appropriate farming technology can be achieved also in the urban areas. Barangay Bagong Silang in Caloocan City is one of the Philippines' biggest villages in terms of size and population. In this urban poor community on the northern edge of the sprawling metropolis, a Sibat-assisted urban gardening project flourishes. The women and men of a basic ecclesial community usually start their day with a prayer before starting their collective work. On every available space around their village chapel and on their rooftops, they raise vegetables on ingenious plots and recycled metal or plastic containers. Allow me to introduce two wonderful women partners. Sister Thelma is the secretary of the core group of the Basic Ecclesial Community of Bagong Silang, Phase 9.
Malaki yung naitutulong. Gawa kasi nung, yung everyday na lang po na imbis na bibili ng gulay sa palengke, dito na. Tsaka may income din naman po kami. Gawa kasi nung yung iba, pagka gustong bumili, kinukuha din namin para pambili naman po ng walis dito sa simbahan.
Sister Pen is the coordinator of the Para Technicians for Urban Organic Food Production.
Unang-una po, ito isa sa naging nilunsad ng aming parokya ng nasa Santo Niño pa kami sa pangunguna ni Father Nonoy Benitez nang pinatin kami ng seminar sa Sibat at inatasan kaming magkaroon ng garden. Ito po ay organic vegetable. So wala po itong chemical. Ligtas kami sa kalusukan. At sa aming samahan bilang BEC at nakapalob ang Bukluran, ito po ay nagkakaroon kami ng pagkakaisa, pagdadamayan, at higit sa lahat yung pagmamahalan at pagtutulungan na sama-sama kami dito tuwing umaga sa garden.
With determination, persistence, and a steady supply of good cheer, great things are possible. Sibat helps to address the need for sustained capacity building through its School for Sustainable Development in Mangarita, Capas, Tarlac, and in many areas outside where development work is being carried out by the collaboration among local NGOs, POs, and Sibat. Farmers and NGO workers come to the school to train on various aspects of development work. Sustainable agriculture is a main feature of the school. Here, farmer practitioners and learners gather to study intensively the fundamentals of sustainable agriculture in relation to the particular conditions they confront in their respective areas. Farmers who have undertaken the farmer technician trainings provided by Sibat in their localities also come here to study more advanced techniques and skills. The Mangarita Organic Farm and the surrounding lowland and upland organic farms of farmers in Capas, Tarlac provide a practicum site for learners. The trainings provide learners the opportunity to share their experiences with those from other areas. The school is a venue for disseminating competencies. Farmers of Tarlac were the first trainees of the center. Among the trainees turned pioneers of organic farming in Tarlac is local farmer Kong Carling.
Ang Sibat, malaking tulong sa mga farmer. Lalong-lalo na dahil katabi ko lang yung Mangarita Farm. Malaking tulong ang nagagawa nila sa mga farmer. Lalo na ngayon nag-uumpisang mag-organize na mga farmer ang Sibat para gumamit ng organic yung mga farmer.
To provide trainings to the many interested farmer groups, the center is managed by Teng de la Cruz, the coordinator for the Sustainable Agriculture Training Center.
Ang programang yun ay magbigay ng pagsasanay sa mga farmers tungkol sa organic farming o sustainable agriculture. Tinuturo sa mga farmers yung aktwal na pagsasagawa halimbawa ng biofertilizer, ng mga formulasyon halimbawa sa pamatay peste, mga botanical pesticides na tinatawag natin. At saka mga ilang pang mga production system like intercropping, crop rotation, yung mga transplanting methods. Yung mulching, yung mga ganon, no? Yung mga tinuturo natin dito.
Meg is one of Sibat's younger staff whose work and passion is sharing knowledge with the farmers.
Tinuturo ay tungkol sa sustainable agriculture. Ayan po, para sa likas-kayang pagpuproduktor ng mga magsasaka natin dito sa ating bayan. Siguro sa ngayon dahil kasi simula ko pa lang, isa sa mga nagbigay sa akin ng kaligayahan ay yung makilala ko yung mga farmers na inorganize ng Sibat at maibahagi sa kanila yung nalalaman ko rin. At kung maaari, maintindihan ko rin yung kanilang mga condition, yung kanilang mga sitwasyon.
Through the School for Sustainable Development, Sibat hopes to sustain the great legacy of development work carried out through organized collaboration among various sectors in Philippine rural poor areas. The problems of poverty and underdevelopment remain a challenge now as it was since Sibat's establishment 26 years ago. The appropriate technology work of Sibat and its partners have made significant strides in addressing poverty at the countryside. But we are not finished yet. There's so much to be done, especially if new problems arise. The persistent socioeconomic problems addressed by Sibat's appropriate technology have been compounded by an urgent concern. This is the phenomenon of climate.